Eritrea has a coastline of more than 1,350 kilometers along the southwestern coast of the Red Sea, rich in diverse marine resources and habitat. The territorial waters cover an area of about 55,000 square kilometers. The region, particularly the coastal line and the offshore islands, embrace an average of 31 degrees Celsius, while in the Danakil Depression, which is 100 meters below sea level, the temperature is 38 to 50 degrees Celsius. The harsh climate never prevents people from living in and gaining from the diverse resources and from what the sea offers. The Red Sea is home to 360 islands, with Dahla Kabir being the largest in geographic and economic terms. The sea and the long coastline demonstrate a great potential for the growth of the tourist industry. The coastline boasts some of the finest, longest and purest beaches in the world. Marine resources are very important from the point of view of food and economic security, especially in developing countries. Most of the countries that have an access to oceans and seas are using different methods and techniques to exploit their marine resources to achieve their food security and develop their economy. Eritrea, as one of the countries that has sea gate, also aims at using its marine resources to ensure food security. Eritrea has a coastline of more than 1,100 kilometers long in the Red Sea. The Eritrean part of the Red Sea is one of the underexploited potential marine resources in the world. It's believed that Eritrea has the potential of maximum sustainable yield of 80,000 metric tons of fishery and numerous marine resources. The Eritrean marine resources are vastly distributed within the long coast and below the beautifully and carefully preserved sea. The marine biodiversity in the Red Sea spans from the unicellular phytoplankton, seedlings, to the enormous whales. Over 1,000 different species of fish and 250 types of corals are found in the Red Sea. Besides invertebrates, mollusks and gastropods, as well as marine plants, such as the three different types of mangrove trees, are among the major resources of the Red Sea. According to studies conducted over the past 28 years, it has been confirmed that the depth of the Eritrean Sea is also a haven for 11 types of seagrass, 5 types of marine turtles, as well as over 72 different marine bird species. Furthermore, 70 different types of sea cucumber, with high economic significance, are found in the Red Sea. Sea turtles turtles are some of the very few creatures that have survived the global climate changes over a long period of time. 5 species of sea turtles are found in the Red Sea at large, while 2 of these species are located in the coasts and islands of the northern Red Sea region. According to research conducted by the Ministry of Marine Resources, 70% of the 110 islands used by the sea turtles to lay their eggs are located in this region. The sea turtles lay their eggs most frequently and a relatively bigger amount on the islands of the Dahalag Archipelago. Marine experts say that coral reefs are shallow tropical water ecosystems, largely restricted to areas between 30 degrees north and 30 degrees south latitudes. Coral reefs rank among the most biologically productive and diverse of all natural ecosystems. Most of the corals around the Dahalag Archipelago are very attractive and are located near the seashores and the islands, but they get scarce as they get closer to the Hawakil Island. The high quality and most diverse coral reefs are scattered over an area of 15 kilometers, stretching from the Desi Island to the Madot Island. Indeed, the Red Sea region, through its unlimited resources and priceless quality of fish and corals, is and will be playing a significant role in the socio-economic growth of the Eritrean population. At the ecosystem level, coral reefs play significant ecological and economic roles by serving as sheltering, feeding and breeding grounds for numerous marine species, and fishing grounds for coastal communities by fostering the tourism industry, providing protection of coastline against wave and storm surge, preventing erosion and contributing to the formation of sandy beaches and sheltering harbors. There is high diversity of coral and fish in many parts of the coasts and Eritrean islands. At least 38 coral genera and 220 species have been identified and recorded. According to some surveys, there are 78 species of seabirds and shorebirds, of which 22 are known to breed on Eritrean islands, mainly in the summer, while 25 species are true seabirds that belong to families such as tropic bird, booby, gull, tern and cormorant. The remaining utilize the marine environment partly. In addition, more than 50 species of land birds were identified on the Eritrean islands. These diverse bird species are found in 181 islands. The two groups of seabirds and shorebirds are basically distinguished by their relative spatial location. Seabirds spend the greater part of their lives at sea, diving to hunt and sometimes going to the shores to lay eggs, whereas shorebirds spend most of their time in the intertidal zone, mainly feeding by scavenging fishes or invertebrates that were washed out to the shore. Mangrove forests in Eritrea are found along about 380 kilometers of coastline and cover an area of about 70 square kilometers. Most of the mangrove forests are found in areas where some seasonal freshwater runoff occurs and in low-lying, poorly draining areas behind dune ridges, which are flooded infrequently. Towards the south, dense mangrove forests are found near Asab Bay and in patches around Diol. Some offshore islands, such as Muzari, Norah, Harena, and Dergamam Kabir, also have dense mangroves. Mangroves of the Red Sea and Eritrea are nurseries for several commercial fish species, protect coral reefs by trapping sediment loads from the seasonal rainwater influx, and also act as an important breeding, nesting and wintering sites for migratory birds, both shorebirds and seabirds. In addition, the presence of mangroves in numerous places stabilizes the coastline by protecting it against the effects of storms and wave actions. Mangroves also play an important role in the maintenance of other ecosystems, including wetlands, salt marshes, seagrass beds, and coral reefs. About 380 kilometers of the Eritrean mainland and island coastlines are covered by mangrove forests. Of the seven mangrove species in the Red Sea area, three are found on the mainland and numerous islands.